Welcome to SAP Datasphere. You wonder how to get started? Just watch this overview video that will take a quick look at the most important apps and the first steps to take in SAP Datasphere to create your first graphical view and an analytic model. The sidebar allows you to navigate to the different apps. Keep in mind that as SAP Datasphere is a cloud-secured environment, it depends on the roles and permissions assigned to your user what you are allowed to do. The upper part contains apps mainly used for modeling. In the Repository Explorer, you can browse and create objects. In the Data Marketplace, you can purchase data products. In the Business Builder, business users can combine, refine, and enrich Data Builder objects. In the Data Builder, modelers can create or import tables and views. You can apply role-level security to your objects with data access controls. In the lower part of the site navigation area, you can find administration apps like Space Management, System Monitor, Content Network, User Management, and Transport. Well, what do you have to do first to get started? The first step is to get access to a space. A space is a secure area in which space members can ingest and model data. Each space is managed by one or more space administrators, and its data is not accessible outside of the space unless it is shared to another space or exposed for consumption. So, an administrator must create a space for you or assign you to a space. For now, I assume the role of the administrator and create a space and add the members. The administrator can allocate storage and create access to databases or create connections. To create your first model, go to the Data Builder. First, we will import a CSV file to create a table and fill it with the data from the file. Select your file. Repeat these steps to upload several files. Now you need to add semantic information to your tables. The product text table provides labels for attributes and other entities. Set the semantic usage to text. Define the keys and the semantic types of the attributes. Save and deploy your changes. You can define the product table as a dimension. A dimension contains attributes that can be used to analyze and categorize measures. Set the semantic type to dimension. Set a key. And create a text association. Create a mapping. Now you can create your first graphical view. In a view, you can combine, filter, enrich, and otherwise prepare data. Click New Graphical View to open the editor. The graphical interface supports drag and drop, so you can just drag and drop your sources onto the canvas. Define the view as a fact, as it contains one or more measures and attributes. There are several tools for creating operators and performing other actions. You can create input parameters, associations, and data access controls. You can filter data, calculate columns, and aggregate data. For example, you can create a calculated column to calculate the unit price. For for products for which there are no sales numbers, define a null value as a price cannot be calculated. Divide gross sales by quantity. You can preview the data to see if it looks as expected. Here's my calculated unit price. You can now easily create an analytic model from the view. Analytic models are the foundation for making data ready for consumption in SAP Analytics Cloud. It has richer modeling capabilities than the graphical view and offers more calculation features. You can create different types of variables, filters, and measures. Deploy the model so that it can be used in a story in SAP Analytics Cloud. You can use the analytical preview first to check your data. And this is just an introduction of what you can do in SAP Datasphere. For more information, check out help.sap.com.